गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 9 रे ऑप्टिक्स एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज रिफ्रैक्शन थ्रू प्रिज्म। तो दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी वेरी जनरल टॉपिक। वी हैव ऑलरेडी गॉन थ्रू दिस टॉपिक इन क्लास 10, राइट। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज प्रिज्म? एक्चुअली prism is a 3D structure with two refracting surfaces and a base. That bounded medium is called prism, right? Now see at the screen, there is a three-dimensional figure, and moreover, these two rectangular surfaces are refracting surfaces, means a ray will refract through this surface and this surface. And the third surface, that is called base. It means this surface, which is in inward direction, that is the base. So the invisible surface in this diagram is base. And the angle opposite to the base is called prism angle. This is the prism angle, and we are taking this prism angle as A, right? Now rays are incident at one refracting surface, and after double refraction from this surface and this surface, it emerges out from this one, right? So this is the structure of prism, right? Now we are talking about the refraction, right? So when a ray incident at first refracting surface, it refracts. It is going from rarer to denser medium, so it bends towards the normal. And at the second surface, it is going from denser medium to rarer medium, so it will move away from the normal. Now these two surfaces are refracting surfaces. It means BC is base, and the angle opposite to the base is angle of prism or prism angle, right? Now we are drawing the normals. This is the angle of incidence for the first surface, and this is angle of refraction. This is angle of incidence at second surface, and this one is angle of refraction. Now see, this is called angle of incidence, this is called angle of emergence, right? Now these two angles, this angle is angle of refraction R1, and at the second, this R2 is angle of incidence for AC surface. Now ray is going from denser to rarer medium, right? So this angle is angle of refraction, right? Now see the deviation. This is the angle O. So if in the absence of a prism, the ray, the direction of incident ray is in this line, this is dotted line, but due to prism, it suffers from double refraction and it emerges out in this direction. So what will be the angle of deviation? This one. This is the angle of deviation, and this angle of deviation is del. Means the angle between incident ray and refracted ray through the prism is angle of deviation. Now we have to calculate all these things. Now first of all, in quadrilateral angle, quadrilateral APOQ, angle A, angle P, angle Q and angle O, the sum of these angles is equal to 360 degrees, but angle P and angle Q are at 90 degrees, right? It means 90 plus 90, 180. It means sum of angle A and angle O is equal to 180 degrees, right? Since angle P and angle Q are 180 degrees, so we can write it as A plus O is equal to 180 degrees. Right? In the quadrilateral, since angle Q and angle PR 90 degree, right? Now see, triangle OPQ. Now this is O, P and Q. In this triangle, the sum of angles is equal to 180 degree, means angle O plus angle R plus angle R2 is equal to 180 degree. So we can write it as R1 plus R2 plus O is equal to 180 degree. This is second equation, right? Now, in triangle DPQ, now this is D, this is P, this is Q. So this angle will be I minus R1. Since this angle is I, so this angle should be I. But this angle is R1, so the remaining angle is I minus R1. And this angle is E minus R2. Now, del is the exterior angle and interior opposite angles are I minus R1 and E minus R2. We can write it as del is equal to I minus R1 plus E minus R2. Right? After reshuffling, we can write it as del is equal to I plus E minus R1 plus R2. We are taking minus sign common from R1 and R2. Right? Now, from equation 1 and 2, these two equations we are comparing. So, we can get A is equal to R1 plus R2. Kaise? The right hand side of both the equation is 180 degree. Right? Here in left hand side O, here in equation 2 also O. It means A equal to R1 plus R2. We can write it as A equal to R1 plus R2. So this is the equation A is equal to R1 plus R2. Now substitute this R1 plus R2 is equal to A in third equation, this equation. So we can get del is equal to I plus E minus A. This is A. Right? So this equation becomes. Now this is minus A. When it comes into the left hand side, it will become positive. So we can write it as I plus E is equal to A plus del. Now this is the condition of refraction through prism. In any prism, this condition holds. And whenever the ray refracted from prism, there is always I plus E is equal to A plus del. So this is the condition of refraction through prism. Now you can write it in the statement, sum of angle of incidence and angle of emergence, sum of angle of incidence and angle of emergence is equal to sum of angle of prism, it means A, and angle of deviation. So this is the condition of refraction through prism, right? Now the variation of angle of deviation with angle of incidence. If we change angle of incidence, means I, so this del always varies, right? Now how these two varies with each other? Now see, this is in graph, here is angle of incidence and in y axis this is angle of deviation. Now the graph is like this. At lower angle of incidence, higher value of angle of deviation. But when we increase this angle of incidence, angle of deviation decreases up to a certain value, right? Afterward, if we increase the angle of incidence, angle of deviation also increases. It increases after this value. So the minimum value of angle of deviation, that is called del M, minimum deviation. So I equal to E, it means there is angle of deviation. This is the condition of minimum deviation. Whenever the ray of light deviates minimum through the prism, then the angle of incidence becomes equal to angle of emergence. right? Now see, when angle of incidence increases, angle of deviation decreases. At a particular value of angle of incidence, the angle of deviation becomes minimum. This angle is angle of minimum deviation, means del m. This is del m. Now what happens at del m, I becomes equal to E. If I equal to E, it means R1 and R2 also equal. And we are assuming R1 and R2 is equal to R. So, if angle of deviation is minimum angle of deviation, the angle of incidence equal to angle of emergence. Right? Now, we are going to calculate refractive index of prism. Now, we are going to derive the formula for refractive index of material of prism. So, we should use the Snell's law. Now, in previous equation, A is equal to R1 plus R2. So, we can write R1 and R2 is equal to R. So, we can get R is equal to A by 2. If R1 and R2 equal to small r, so R equal to A by 2. Now, similarly, from the condition of refraction through prism, we can write here I. So, we can get 2I is equal to A plus del M. Since I equal to E, where del is equal to del M. So, I equal to A plus del M by 2. Now, we got R and I. We have to substitute these values in Snell's law. And we will easily find out the refractive index. Now, mu is equal to sin I by sin R. So, we can substitute the value and we have a value of refractive index of material of prism, right? So, basically in this topic, we are calculating the refractive index of material of prism, right? Now, refraction by small angle prism, right? Small angle prism. For the small angle of incidence. If angles are very small, we can write sin theta equal to theta and tan theta equal to theta. Now, for every prism, we can write mu is equal to sin I by sin R for the first refracting surface. And for the second refracting surface, we can write mu equal to sin E divided by sin R. Right? Now, these values are very small. It means angles are very small. So we can write sin I is equal to I and sin R1 is equal to R. Similarly, for this equation, we can write mu is equal to E by R2 since angles are very small. So we have to calculate the value of I and E from these two equations. So we will get I is equal to mu R1 and here E is equal to mu R2. Now, substitute these values in condition through prism, right? So, we can, first of all, we can get the sum of I and E is equal to I plus E is equal to mu R1 plus R2. Now, R1 plus R2 is nothing but A. So, I plus E is equal to mu A. Now, substitute this value in condition of refraction through prism. So, we can get A plus del is equal to mu A. So, del is equal to A mu minus 1. This is the formula for small angle prism when angle of incidence is very small. Right? Now, this equation will be required in dispersion of light through the prism. When a light ray incident at the prism, it splits into 7 colors. This phenomena is called dispersion. So, in the next lecture, we will go through the dispersion of light through the prism. For today, this is the topic. These are the topic. Thank you. Thank you very much.